Good morning, students. So from today we will start unit 2. The name of the unit is Amazing Animals. So everyone please take out your textbooks. Yeah, I'm sharing one on the screen as well. Okay. So unit 2, Amazing Animals. The activity 1. Let's read activity 1. Okay. This unit is about some of the amazing animals that share our world. Now this whole unit is about animals which live with us in this world. Okay, so now which animal or insect do you see in this photograph? Correct, it is a butterfly. So over here you have to write butterfly. What animal shape do you see? It is the shape of a butterfly. So come on, let's write butterfly over here. Butterfly. Now, you can see that in this butterfly, many words are written like fly, blue, flowers, color, antenna, insect, flying, flowers, black, yellow, cocoon, butterfly, correct? Now, out of these so many words, you have to write 5 words over here. What words do you find in the shape? Okay, not all. You have to write any 5 words that you see. Any 5. Clear? This we will discuss in the next video class that we have. Now let's move ahead. Let's come to activity number 2. Okay. Now this is a story about a battle in the jungle. This story is divided into various parts. This is the first part of the story. So once I will read the story and then after I read, you have to read the whole story, okay? As the way I have read. Once upon a time, all the animals that walked on land and all the birds and insects that flew in the sky began to quarrel about who was the smartest and strongest. At first, they spoke softly. Then, slowly, they became angrier and louder. The tigers growled and the wolves howled. The birds gave loud cries and cackles. The insects buzzed as loudly as they could. At last, an old parrot said, "Stop shouting. Let's not waste our time and energy in the talk. Let's fight." The animals laughed at the bird's idea. "What?" said the lion. "Can you fight us? Don't be foolish. I can bite harder than any one of you." The elephant said, "I can lift a whole tree and fight you all at once." "We will easily defeat you." "Will you?" said the parrot. "We'll see about that. Get ready to fight us." The lion became the commander of all the animals. The parrot became the commander of all the birds. The lion called all the animals together and gave them a drill for practice. They marched for long hours. He gave them a lot of good food too. The poor birds did not have good food and they did not practice. Instead, they had a meeting with their friends, the insects. This is the first part of the story. I will explain the story in our next video lecture, which is on Zoom. Okay, so everyone has to attend the lecture on Zoom. In homework, you have to rewrite these words, word meanings, okay? Quarrel means angry disagreement. When you are angry at someone and arguing about something. Okay, you have to write means quarrel. Then, mane. What do you mean by mane? Mane means long hair from the necks of certain animals. Okay, you must have seen a zebra or a giraffe and on their neck they have long hair. Really? That is called mane. Battle means to fight. Sting means to hurt with a sudden sharp pain. when a needle hits you, it suddenly hits you. So it is very, very sharp. Correct? So it is called the sting. When a honeybee bites you, it's called the honeybee has stinged me. Correct? The honeybee has stung me. Now roar. To utter a loud, deep, rumbling sound. Have you seen a lion roar? Yes, that is called a loud, deep and rumbling sound. Now spy. Spy means to watch closely and secretly. Okay, when you watch someone secretly, okay, that is called spy. Nazar rakhte hai na kisi pe, that is called spying. Now these are the word meanings that have been given for the chapter. You have to write this in your notebook. Let's come to activity number 3. Okay, so this is homework. Activity number 3, this is also homework. Let's read. 3 characters have spoken in the story so far. Who are they? So character means names that have been taken in the story. So what all names have been taken in the story? You have to write the 3 names which have been taken in the story. Clear? So to see the story name, we will move ahead. Let's see what names have been taken. The first name that has been taken is Parrot. P-A-R-R-O-T, Parrot. The second name is Lion. L-I-O-N, Lion. And the third name is the Elephant. So these are the 3 characters which have been told about in the story till now. Okay, so you have to write Parrot, Lion and Elephant. Okay. Now look carefully at the story. How do you know who is speaking? How does the punctuation in the story show you that the characters are speaking? Notice and copy one of the quotations with its punctuation from one of the characters. Now if we see the story, how do we know that who is speaking this dialogue? Now how do we know that who is speaking the dialogue? I can lift a whole tree and fight you all at once. We will easily defeat you. So how do you know that it's a dialogue and who is speaking it? Yes, because of this punctuation mark. This is called inverted commas. Okay. Now when inverted commas open, it means the dialogue has started. And when over here on the next page you see inverted commas have closed, this means that the dialogue has finished. This means comma open. We write the dialogue over here and here we close the comma. Clear? So how do we know that someone is speaking? So we know with the help of the punctuation inverted comma. So how does the punctuation show that whenever a person is speaking a dialogue, inverted commas open. Whenever the dialogue is finished, the inverted commas close. This is how we understand that a character is speaking in the story. Now we have to write one of the dialogue. Quotation means dialogue from any one of the character. From any of the dialogue written in the story, you have to write one dialogue over here. Understood? So activity 3 is also homework. We will read the further story in the next class. So everyone start doing your homework right now. Okay, this is all for today. Bye, take care.